Hi, I'm Mike Thompson, and welcome to the third and final installment of my video tutorial series.
Okay, so what you're seeing right now is what I'd like to call the fun part. It's the detailing. So this is where I go in and add seams to the costumes and wrinkles and the compression areas of the fabric and all that stuff that nobody would probably really care about, but I do a lot. So I think just putting in these little highlights and shadows in the folds and wrinkles and things makes it much more believable. So, you know, you may not even catch it on your first read. You might look at the piece the first time and, you know, you see the character, but you don't see these things. But, you know, you look at it again and you'll see a little bit more. That's kind of what I like for people to do with my paintings is notice a little bit more every time they look at it. You know, it's like one of those Russian nesting dolls where you take one out and there's another one inside and one inside of that one and so on and so forth. But that's what's going on right here. Just really putting a lot of little goodies in here. You can see on her backpack I put a button, which is one of the things I did with my last turtle painting. I had a New York button on his tech jacket, or his tech vest rather, and I love hip hop. So I always like to throw those little things on there. The button that Gwen has on her backpack is of another Gwen variation in Marvel, which is the Deadpool Gwen, or Gwenpool. So, don't know if anybody's going to catch that, but they should know now. And you can see that, you know, I kind of cooked the details in her goggles a little more and made them feel a little more believable and went and changed. In the original render, I had the webbing on her hoodie and arm as red. And after looking at the comic, I noticed that it's actually supposed to be pink. Like, that's her whole deal is pink and that turquoise blue. So put that on there, figured out the webbing. I took some cues from the new Spider-Man Homecoming movie and, you know, the Marvel aesthetic in general in their films, and put some pretty interesting little cut lines on her shoulder and right above her collarbone. Just something that they're doing, little hard surface details that it just adds a level of interest to the clothing. So it's not just cloth. But what I'm doing now is just putting a reflection in the goggle of the inside of her hood, because why not? I think I'm getting pretty close to the end on this one. You can see I got rid of that generic background, which was a gradient and like super boring, and painted in a New York City skyline. Didn't really feel like messing around with buildings back there, so I just kind of threw some pigeons in and blurred their wings a little bit. So around this time is when I would be winding down the piece and throw on the signature as the last thing you always do. You can see I have a lot of layers. Like, I'm not super efficient when it comes to layers until the very end. Right here I'm just kind of taking my signature and figuring out where I want to put it on the painting. Once that is done, I'll flatten all those layers and save it as the final image. And that's usually around the time that I just kind of show the client, get the approval, and then ship it off to them, the high-res file.
I hope you enjoyed this short series. If you missed out on parts 1 and 2, just click the link below. Good luck and keep creating.